When First Player sent me their steampunk fans, I thought they were pretty cool. But their product branding kind of confused me. They didn't look particularly steampunky at all. The next thing they've thrown my way is... closer, I guess. It's not nearly steampunky enough, but still closer. Gears are pretty steampunk, just throw gears on it. First Player's Steampunk Lite MK5 RGB mechanical keyboard is a love it or hate it kind of thing. It's got the full-size mechanical keyboard standards you should come to expect, like full key rollover, media and quick launch keys huddled up in the function row, double molded injection ABS keycaps, an ergonomic design, a 1.6 meter braided USB cable, rubber pads and fold-out feet around the bottom, and RGB. Any non-RGB keyboard nowadays might as well be banished to the Shadow Realm, where there is no light. But you need light to make shadows, so how does that work? And then you've got some other more variable things, like a keycap puller, switch puller for the 5 extra included CIY blue replacement switches, a water and dust resistance rating of IPX7, and the Otemu blue switches installed in the board that sound a little like this. And finally, driverless RGB control. You've got access to 10 effects, various game modes from numbers 1 through 5 with the option to customize your own, static, a type lighting per key effect, rainbow wave, a marquee effect, a type lighting ripple effect, another type lighting effect they call touch and go, a wave effect that flows with a strange amount of satisfaction, a self-explanatory breathing effect, and neon, which is effectively a color shift. All effects have brightness, speed, and direction control where applicable, in addition to mixing colors or being bound to a static color of either red, blue, green, yellow, purple, cyan, or white. As for the keyboard's primary gimmick, let's go around to the keycaps, which are, well, round. The typewriter-esque keycaps are slightly concave to catch your fingers, with the exception of the convex spacebar, and I had no issues adapting from the traditional familiar keycaps to these, but I will note that unlike most standard keyboards that sort of curve as you move from the bottom of the keyboard to the top, this one has a linear incline. It's a subtle difference and didn't cause any issues or discomfort for me, but it is noticeable and should be considered if this is on your radar. In terms of use, the keyboard was actually pretty pleasant to work with. Shape aside, the ABS keycaps feel sturdy and satisfying to the touch. The stem is standard, so the keycaps can be replaced if you- why would you buy this keyboard to replace the keycaps? That's the entire selling point. The switches are reliable with no unexpected actions, and the lighting distribution is pretty consistent. There are, however, a few ways this keyboard steampunked me. The braided cable is red and black, which doesn't make sense for an RGB peripheral. Secondary functions on the keycaps should be consistent with the main lettering so light can peek through, and why doesn't anyone make the lock indicators match with the rest of the board? There is some subtle steampunk light branding in red above the arrow keys, but it's a darker shade so it doesn't stand out nearly as much as that cable does. The font also seems a little bold to me, but that could be just fine depending on your preference. Besides, anything with the word steampunk ought to be a little on the head-turning side anyway, right? There is no included wrist rest, which I would have appreciated, but some of you are a little more restless than I, so it may not bother you as much. The last thing I want to poke fun at is their mildly conflicting marketing. I mentioned a water resistance rating of IPX7 earlier, meaning you can dunk it in water up to a meter deep for 30 minutes, but they also warn you against putting the keyboard underwater. Are you getting nervous? Whatever it may be, you probably shouldn't be gaming in the bathtub anyway, so take that specification with a grain of salt. But not salt water. Definitely do not put this thing in salt water. For $60, you get a pretty standard RGB mechanical keyboard with some pretty cool keycaps. If you're a square, these won't be for you, in which case I suggest you check out their Fire Rose keyboard, something just as hot that I reviewed in the card up top. But if this is a style you really like, this one is definitely a keeper. And so that's all I have to say about that. Like, dislike, comment, subscribe, share, leave me questions if you've got them. Thanks for watching. My name is Steven and I am a little dim. Bye bye. Not gearly. Various game modes from numbers 1 through 5. Something in my head squeaked. What was that? Various game modes from.
Oh, I knew I messed something up.
Double molded injection. in America. The typewriter-esque keycaps are slightly concave to catch your fingers, yeah. Unlike most standard keyboards that sort of curve as you move from the bottom, the ABS keycaps feel sturdy and satisfying to the touch. There are, however, a few ways this keyboard has steampunked me. Why doesn't anyone make the lock indicator? Great. The font also seems a little bold to me, but that could be just... There's no included wrist rest, which I would have definitely appreciated, but some of you are a little more restless than I... Restless. Good. That's good. There's no included wrist rest, which I would have appreciated, but some of you are a little more restless than I... that's lacking in taste a little bit.